Hello everybody, and welcome to the first part of my Captain Toad Treasure Tracker playthrough. This is going to be a full playthrough of the game, and I'm going to go through and collect everything that you can in each level and stuff like that. For those that don't know, this is kind of like a spin-off game of Super Mario 3D World. In that game, Captain Toad had his own levels. Basically, it's an expansion of that concept, the concepts of the Captain Toad levels in that game. So, it's like a puzzle platformer, but it's a really good game, and I've enjoyed it a lot so far from what I've played. Okay, so we're just going to move ahead here and talk to Toadette. Well, follow Toadette, not talk to her. Oh, a quick explanation of the controls. The right stick on the gamepad, or you can tilt the gamepad too. It moves the camera. The Y button turns on and off his headlight there. The X button zooms in. Then the A button, you can pick up stuff. Or the B button. But there's nothing to pick up here yet. So let's go on. Okay, and Toadette found a star. So this is the first star of the game. Maybe. Okay, this book basically has all the worlds and the levels in the game. This is like you don't have like a hub world or a level select or anything like that. You just go through the book. This is the first part. The secret is in the stars. What I'm going to do for this playthrough is as I go through each level, I'm going to stop each video. Like there's like a little divider. I'm going to stop them after each one. So this is the first one. So the first level here is Plucky Past Beginnings. So... alright, let's head in. Since this is the first level of the game, this kind of introduces a lot of the gameplay elements that you're going to see throughout the game. These little sprouts out of the ground, you can hit the A button and pick them up, or the B button. I usually hit the A button myself. And then these right here, these jewels, there's three of them in each level. If you're going for 100% completion, you obviously want to try to find as many as possible. But yeah, I'm going to go through each level and show all the locations for those. Throw the veggies. Yeah, some of these will have veggies. You can throw the veggies at enemies. Some parts of the level, like that power block, you can throw them at that too. Throw it at the sign there. And they do drop a coin each time you, like, I guess toss the veggie. That gets kind of important in some levels, but I'll explain that later, I guess. And then, just like in the Super Mario Brothers games, the coins, when you get them 100, you get an extra life, but like I said, the coins do have another purpose in some levels, and I'll explain that later. Oh, wait. Let me go around here. Oh, wait, not yet. I'm gonna go up here first. Okay, this is a shy guy. He's been in plenty of Mario games. They're probably the most common enemy in this one, but they're pretty easy to defeat. You have to throw like something at him because Captain Toad can't attack normally. You know, all he can do is just that and that. So you have to find something to throw at them or some way to attack them. Okay, and this is a pickaxe. It allows you to break stuff. You actually want to go down here and break this real quick. You can't jump with it. So you can just, you know, hit stuff, hit as much stuff as possible. The gray blocks are the ones that you want to aim for, though, if there's any around. And up here we have plenty of things to pluck. If you use a pickaxe on these, it actually just plucks them for you, basically. But I really wanted to get that that block that was down there. Anyway, as you can see, there is a gold mushroom there. So let's grab that. That's what was behind the gray block there. That's worth 50 coins. And there's actually a sign, not a sign, like a little wanted poster, I guess. That's the bird at the beginning. That's cool. Okay. Oh, I forgot about the plunger here. Yeah, one of the things that, if you played Super Mario 3D World or watched my playthrough of it, when you rotate the camera in the Captain Toad levels in that game, you could find like different secrets and different, you know, things to explore. This is no different. You're going to have to rotate the camera a lot to find some stuff. Oops. Okay, and up here we have the Toad Brigade. There's a mushroom. If you get hit, you turn into like small toad or something like that. The mushroom will make you grow back into normal size. Oh, thanks, buddy. Yeah, sometimes they'll give you jewels and stuff like that, so it's kind of important to interact with them. He's kind of happy to see him, and this one right here is funny. You take a nap. Okay. And that should be it for this level. It's a pretty short level, but it's basically here to introduce the concepts of the game, like I said earlier. Alright, yeah, this game is a lot of fun. I'm actually having a lot of fun. I'm going through another file. Well, the thing is, you only get one file in this game. I was kind of disappointed. Well, as far as I know. I mean, I think if you back out... Actually, let's check that. Oh, the bonus. I'll explain that later. Yeah, there's only one file. That's kind of disappointing. But yeah, I've been just going, logging into a different Nintendo ID, and I did that for the first time through. So this one is my like main ID. But anyway, this is the second level, Walleye Tumble Temple. Okay, this one, don't go forward. I'll explain that later, but you don't want to go forward because it breaks the bridge, and that actually isn't something you want to do. These guys we've seen before in Super Mario 3D World. You can just do that to make them stop. Okay, so we're going to cross this little bridge here and get that jewel. There we go. Okay, right now, the gamepad... Oh, this game is only compatible with the gamepad, but it uses a lot of gamepad functionality, so there's no way they could have had it compatible with like the Pro Controller or anything like that. But the gamepad mirrors what you're doing on the TV, but in some levels, you'll see a different view. Like, there's one minecart level. If you watched, I think it was at E3, they showed the minecart level there, and... You know, you saw a first-person view on the gamepad, but on the TV, it's like a third-person view. Right, let's walk over here. I'm going to get everything eventually. I think there's something I missed down here, actually. He, like, calls out. It's funny. Okay. Oh, wait. Oh, wait there. Okay. I did not mean to do that, but I forgot about the coins down here, so I might as well just grab them. You can zoom in and see, like, the transparent coins. Okay, I do have to go back through here, which kind of stinks. If you don't have any veggies left, you just have to, you know, quickly run through that little doorway. I don't know if I could have made that. I wanted to be cautious. Okay, and this is what I was trying to get to before, and I kind of forgot about it. But when this goes over here, you can actually go in this part. There's jewel number two. Okay, the third one is up there. And getting up there is pretty easy. Here we go. We just have to wait for this to rotate. So we can go in this hole. There we go. And what it'll do is it'll rotate and allow you to go to the top. Okay, I'm gonna grab this jewel here. There we go. And that's it, we're done. That's another short level. The levels actually do get really lengthy as you go through the game. They get, some of them will take a pretty long time. Okay, and the reason I said don't go for that jewel at the beginning is the bridge will break. There are, every level has like an achievement. I don't know what the in-game term is, but it's basically an achievement. So this one here was didn't destroy the temple's bridge. This one here is collect the gold mushroom. There are some where you have to collect a certain amount of coins. There are some where you can't be seen by enemies. It varies between levels. It's something fun to aim for. Okay, and this is the third level, Touchstone Trouble. I'm not going to be able to do the achievement the first time through, but I'm going to come back and do it, because it's a little bit more complicated than that. Well, I wonder if you can do it your first time. I don't think I'm going to do it anyway, but... Okay. But this one, you have to use the game, like the touchscreen on the gamepad, to slide these around. I'm trying to remember this one. This one took me like a few tries to get my first time through. Wait, did I go down here? No. Okay, we need a key. Okay, so let's go over here. Oops. I hit the A button one too many times. Okay, but the key is, for some reason, underground. I did it again. So let's take the key over to the door over here. And it's another gem. Cool. Actually, I'm missing the second gem, but we're gonna get it in a sec. I can't remember where it is. Oh wait, there it is. Okay, I think we just shift this. Oop. Not that one. Ah, I keep hitting the wrong one. Here we go. Oh, wait. I keep, like, I'm not using the stylus, I'm just using my thumb, and I keep hitting between the two. So I'm hitting the wrong one. Oops. Music here is really relaxing, too. It's nice. Okay. We are almost done. I just have to move this. There we go. Okay, and the achievement for this level is to clear it in only three, like, you have to move the platforms only three times. Let's see if I can do this. It's actually not that difficult to do. It's just you have to kind of remember what moves you need to do in order to get the achievement. Okay. Right, I think I got it. Two, and then three. There we go. Oh yeah, and when you collect the star, if you go through the level again, it shows up as like a translucent one. Cool. Okay, next level, Mushroom Mesa. Okay, this one. This one introduces these birds. When they see you, I'll show you. Like, try to sit on you. I mean, they do take a little bit to land, so they're pretty easy to avoid. What you can do to defeat them... Oh, wait. Is there anything in here? No. This one has something in it. But what you can do to defeat them is, when they land, if there's a veggie nearby, you can just throw it at them. Here's a mushroom, and then there's a jewel over there. We'll get that in a sec. I don't actually know what they're called, jewel or gem. I'm probably going to call them both in the playthrough. Let's move that down so we can grab these. There we go. It's actually pretty funny, because when they start chasing you, they actually get tired after a while. You actually see them, like, put their little hands on their knees and, like, gasp for air. It's pretty funny. Oh, I think the achievement here is to defeat all the enemies. I'm gonna do that real quick. There's actually only one more. It's the other bird. Oops. Okay. Oh, here we go. So yeah, it's like I said earlier, you have to rotate the camera in order to see where you're supposed to go. And I remember this being kind of annoying, because there's the third jewel, you have to... Oh wait, here, this is it. This took me a while to figure out my first time through. There we go. But yeah, there's a little, like an entrance to this part, but you can only see it if you're facing, like, this way. Oops. Alright, let's get this bird real quick. I'm pretty sure this is the achievement here. There's a 1-up. And that should be it. So let's get out of here. It's another short level, but I already knew what I was doing, so that's why it was so short. Yeah, defeat all the enemies. And you don't see what the achievement thing here is until you go through the level at least once. Here's a quick tip. You can open the manual from the home menu. You may make some unexpected discoveries there. I don't think I'm going to do that, but if you don't have the game yet, you can check that out. I mean, if you have the game yourself, you can check that out. Okay, the chase to Pyropuff Peak. We're going to get to this in the next video, and the first level that's going to be in that video is Double Cherry Palace. If you played Super Mario 3D World, the Double Cherry, that was a power-up that was introduced in that game, so we're going to be using it here. Alright everybody, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this first episode, and if you did, please tune in for the next video, which will be up sometime soon. Alright, thanks for watching everybody, see you next time.